दाल लेक। दाल लेक इन श्रीनगर ऑफ जम्मू कश्मीर स्टेट इज एन अर्बन लेक एज इट इज सराउंडेड बाई एन अर्बन एनवायरमेंट। दाल लेक इज द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट इन द स्टेट। इट इज इंटेग्रल टू टूरिज्म एंड रिक्रिएशन इन कश्मीर एंड इज ऑल्सो पॉपुलरली कॉल्ड द लेक ऑफ फ्लावर्स, द जूल क्राउन ऑफ कश्मीर एंड ऑल्सो श्रीनगर्स जूल। द लेक इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट एज अ सोर्स ऑफ कमर्शियल ऑपरेशंस इन फिशिंग एंड वाटर प्लांट हार्वेस्टिंग। द लेक कवर्स एन एरिया ऑफ 18 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर्स। द इकोसिस्टम ऑफ दाल लेक इज इकोलॉजिकली रिच इन एक्वेटिक प्लांट्स। Amongst the various physiochemical experiments conducted on June of 2013, the results show that the water temperature of the lake varied from 4.8 degrees Celsius to 25.6 degrees Celsius, and the pH level of the water is in the alkaline side from 7.34 to 8.2. But drinking water must have a pH value of 6.5 to 8.5. According to an assessment conducted by Dredging Corporation of India, the area of Dal Lake has decreased from over 40%, that is from 18 km square to 10 km square. The DCI assessment also found intense pollution made by solid wastes that flow into the lake, which clogs water from flowing freely and also causes extreme growth of weed water. Hyacinth and the 800 to 900 houseboats sailing around has also contributed majorly to these wastes. Encroachment of the lake has not only decreased its size but also its depth. Sewage lines built in Srinagar dispose untreated sewage directly into the lake, said Muzamil Khurshid Ali, chairman of Green Kashmir, an NGO. The Lakes and Waterways Development Authority, LWDA, estimates in 2017 that due to the sewage water, which is nearly 50 million liters flowing into the Dal Lake daily, out of which 20 million liters are untreated, nearly 80,000 tons of silt, 31,000 kilograms of nitrates, and 4,000 kilograms of phosphates are added annually to the lake. In the past 3 decades, the nitrate and phosphate-rich water has been responsible for gastrointestinal diseases for people living around the lake. Nearly 7,500 people live in the houseboats, and more than 50,000 people populating the small islands dump their wastes into the Dal Lake. Continuous disposal of water has severely depleted the lake's water quality. Oxygen density in the water has come down from 10.2 milligrams per liter to 6.8 milligrams per liter, which are dangerous to aquatic animals who use oxygen which is dissolved in the water. Massive investments of approximately 11 billion rupees are made by the government of India to restore the lake to its original splendor. Chembarambakkam Lake. Chembarambakkam Lake is located in Chennai, Tamil Nadu, about 25 kilometers from Chennai. It is one of the 2 rain-fed reservoirs from where water is drawn to supply to Chennai city. The famous Adyar River originates from this lake. A major part of water supply of the metropolis of Chennai is drawn from this lake. It is the first artificial lake built by Rajendra Chola I. The drying up of the Chembarambakkam Lake contributed majorly to the 2019 drought of Chennai. The full capacity of the lake is 108 million cubic meters. Today, most of the natural inlets of the reservoirs are contaminated with domestic sewage from surrounding houses and even from small-scale industries. Satellite images showed that in a full radius of up to 3 kilometers, hyacinth has covered the water area of the reservoir right in the middle. Chembarambakkam Lake has a turbidity level of 90.1 and the permeable limit is 5.0. Turbidity means that a small amount of light is able to penetrate through the water. This indicates that a high number of particles or sediments are suspended or dissolved in the water. The iron particles of the lake is also at a sky high at 71 grams per liter. However, the permeable amount is 10 grams per liter. Iron overload in water can lead to hemochromatosis, which causes damage to the liver, heart, and pancreas. From this research study, it can be concluded that lake water of the study area is not suitable for drinking purposes and one must do the process of recycling before using it for irrigation as well. So, we must take special care of lake water to prevent further pollution in and around the lake water. Come forward to save our lakes, to keep this environment safe.